I
you're
just.
Like, oh, that sounds like Bob Dylan. It's not.
Are you two an item? Because you're looking at her. Right? It's looking kind of like her.
The next matchmaker, right? The matchmaker's in the movie.
She's wondering,
answer the question. Oh, it's in the movie.
Yeah, we told you. Maybe it would ruin your idea of a film, so.
No, it'd be kind of more fun if you were.
Yeah, it was, Jacob had all of these prosthetics on his face all the time for that whole sequence because it was quite a long time we were shooting that, and everyone was like, "Oh God!" And I'd be like, "Oh Jacob, I'm so sorry. Like, it's not real, Sam. It's not."
Yeah,
know,
nobody.
Sometimes you'd just be like, "Oh God, I can't believe you look." He's kind of lost his way a little bit, as a lot of the youths have been in the Great Depression, and he's lost himself to the bottle.
I was so excited to get into the camera.
Are you wearing your period?
Yeah, I've got great little.
Did you wear them?
Like, off yellow Y fronts.
I actually got locked in it one day.
Oh God.
And it was just me and Connor that just waited for you.
Yeah.
Like, guys, are we gonna let Sam out of the coffin?
There was a safety issue and everybody left and they forgot that I was still in the coffin and I was just sort of waiting there. It's very peaceful, very quiet.
Let Me Die in My Footsteps is my favourite Bob Dylan song.
Being and the suffering that war really is.
No.
Who do you think are the real bad guys?
Well, you know, they're kind of similar. A real family.
Sometimes.
It's a very,
well,
very,
real families
very
can get pretty, you know, intense.
We're very
as well.
Dysfunctional.
Yeah, exactly.
Every family is perfect.
Spoken like, let's stop.
take away that man that he had, and so, okay, what's this guy with more light in his eyes? You're getting knocked over by this dude. What's the guy like with the more light in his eyes? When does he lose it? So,
giving it a go. Also,
we got up to some mischief in Thailand, and, you know.
No chance.
There are some things that should not be said, but, you know, we had a great time. No, we had a great time, you know, like.
Really?
How much blood do you intake per sip?
Per session.
Yeah.
I got COVID. And
although I think we were both kind of hyperventilating slightly because we're breathing so much, which is kind of fun. More maybe Gugu than me because she's in the corset, but.
I think I was really into Where the Wild Things Are when I was a kid. And I had all the toys and I was pretty protective over those toys, one in particular. So yeah, I mean, I was pretty obsessed. You know, I had a name for it that I don't think is from the book, but it's the one with the red hair and the beak. Yeah, the nose, yeah.
What do you call it?
That's my own private name.
Yeah, when you're ready.
I mean, you can barely see anything.
What?
Ready?
One second.
Sorry, okay, I'm ready.
Oh my God. Yes. What idea was that?
Who was it? I think it was Carol, was it?
Oh, that's so cute.
Thank you.
Welcome to Roy Thompson Hall.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. I'll get back soon.
Turned out to support her on her first day of her first run.
Everyone.
And we all give you a big clap after you did.
No, you didn't even give me a clap, you just stood there and looked
at
me really.
We wanted to clap,
so
but we weren't
scary.
Allowed to make any noise, but we were very supportive of you. You did a great job. You were such a good runner. You are.
Shut up, that's so not genuine.
You are, you're
that's
a very good
so
runner.
Not genuine.
Very genuine. Romance that ensues, essentially.
Of course, you're working very closely with the magnificent Tom Wilkinson standing right next to you at the moment. What was that like? Can you talk about that experience?
It was great. I mean, you couldn't ask anything better. Hello. I'm talking about you. It's kind of hard. No, it's great.
It's a lot.
It's a lot. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Straight ahead. Great smile, Sam.
Thank you.
Hi, Sam. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Hi.
Once more into the drink, dear friends, once more, and give a roar for all our English drunk. The most powerful moment.
5 years old.
Hugo Fraser-Tyrett. He's kind of in love with the rules and the secrets. Mythic.
Lestat was meant to be called Lestan.
It is incredibly satisfying walking around New Orleans, pretending and knowing that you're playing Lestat.
Cool. I have that anger and like that annoyance. Like Lestat is always there. He's always coming back.
the fang. I heard you were being like shipped fangs to China, like they're Warby Parker glasses or something. Like, what's that all about?
That's very definitive for him.
Like, do you wear that every day?
Why do you wear that every day?
Okay. It's got a bit of purple on it.
I'm actually, stop us from getting too sexy. Like, your Ken Barton, there's nothing down there.
It didn't work. I think also,
who is the most likely to trip and fall while running from the zombies?
Look at me. I'm Eric. I don't have any.
Just for me.
Not just Halloween, like, you know, dinner parties.
Yeah, casually on the streets.
Yeah, I go to sleep in them.
I'm going to get my fangs if we get to the next season.
The character's name was Willing Blonde originally, which I think we changed to Meredith, which is a much better name. But
who is most likely to get bit and then try to hide their infection from the group?
Oh, we know who that is.
Is this...
There's only one guy left.
Sam?
I think he's probably Sam.
How long do you have to hide it, though?
for eternity.
You just,
and you're good at that.
Giving yourself away.
Mine's like a, it's kind of like a fridge.
not to be reductive.
Not a note, deck of coffee.
Yeah.
With more thrashing and more blood. And I just loved it.
I mean, I think you probably like try and hide it, and then like we can all be a zombie gang together, right?
I mean, I would watch that show too.
So for selfish reasons. Sam just wants to turn us all into zombies.
Yeah. I don't know if this is necessarily true.
Who is most likely to be the last one standing? Sam.
Yeah, Sam.
Sam. Sam.
Kind of for the reasons we just said.
Yeah.
Davigny, of course, he's French and I'm very proud of that. A man equally in love with love, law, and the abolition of slavery.
Like really high
granny pants.
Like high granny pants that came up.
Hey there, fellow immortals.
Make sure you come and see the interview with the vampire now.
Today at 2 PM in Ballroom 20.
I want you so bad, honey, I want you.
Go see Girl from the North Country.
Opposite sides of the story. You know, there's this love of the truth, and there's this sort of disdain for it, if you will.
You go first.
Okay. I found the challenging part is that John goes on a lot of large...
You are going to watch it again.
Yeah.
It's beyond me.
Oh, God, we've got so much love. Okay. Uh-huh. It's 3:25.
Need a cup of tea? Oh, cup of tea, Patsy!
Yes, yes.
I got water. I'd like a cup of coffee.
Sweet coffee.
Yeah.
That was nice.
What is it like?
Her house?
Yeah.
It's beautiful, as you can imagine. She lives in like a forest with mountains and the ocean, and you know. But it's incredible to have such a important figure to be a fan of our movie.
And I'm sorry, yeah, I'm
so fortunate. Yeah.
And tonight, Prince is reported. Yes. Are you going to be rocking out? Are you going to be doing a bit of dancing?
I will be. I will be absolutely dancing to Prince. So I was blown away, you know, to hear about that. So I can't wait.
Amazing. Listen, have a great evening.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
Clearly, menswear in London have chosen the right time. Mm. Burberry, what does that mean to you?
Burberry, I think it's very clean, simple, elegant clothes. I love wearing them. They fit beautifully. I've worn them to quite a few events now, and so I'm really excited to actually come and check out their show. It's my first Burberry show.
Okay, well, they've been quite clever, I suppose, and they've positioned themselves at the issue maybe in Britain as well because of Belle is one.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's lovely.
I know, it's stunning. Have you always been a fan of Burberry?
Yeah, I've worn Burberry a lot, a lot of premieres, so I'm very happy to come out and check it out. And my first Burberry show, so I'm excited, yeah.
And who are you wearing today?
Burberry.
Who'd have thought?
Yeah.
Now, I saw Belle, I thought it was... So you have The Riot Club coming out,
yeah.
And you have probably the best-looking cast ever. I'm kind of assuming not as crazy as...
No way. No. We're much more demure than that, I think. But yeah, we did try one night to actually get as drunk as the boys, but it's kind of impossible, I think.
Do you look chic on the beach? What is your top tip?
To look chic on the beach? Don't try too hard. Yeah.
Pretty much about it. Thank you so much.